Hi, this is Freddie again, and today I'm going to show you all how to use those hammers and those homemade tools that I told you about earlier to form sheet metal. And today I'm going to show you a basic exercise that I learned at Austin Community College in a teacher named Barry George's class. He showed us how to do it. And if you live in Austin, I highly recommend you take his class. It's Barry George, Austin Community College, because he taught me basically exactly what I wanted to learn, how to forge sheet metal into cool looking shapes. And affordably too. Here's what we worked on in that class. This is a torso of a female that I worked on. This is the first thing I ever did in that method, and it was very easy to do, a lot easier than you would think. And here's the back of her. This one's all rusty. This one was rusty, but I cleaned it off, and I'm fixing to show you all how to do it. It's a lot easier than it looks, and it's fun. Okay, so here I basically have it drawn out. I added a little bit of arms to see if it looked right, but I'm not going to cut that part out. And normally what I would do if I was going to make one of these for any other reason than to show you all how to hammer the metal, I would use my anatomy book and measure all the proportions, but for today I'm just going to do it real fast. I like to always make paper templates because you can put it on your sheet in a position that will take up the least amount and you'll have the least amount of waste. Well, that's the idea anyway. Alright, so here I'm going to use the jigsaw because I'm going to try to show you how to do this without using a plasma cutter or anything too expensive. So basically when you use a jigsaw, you want to have a metal cutting blade, and you want to have the sheet metal as close to the edge as you can because it gives it support and keeps it from wobbling so much. You can put some kind of lubricant where you're going to cut, like grease, bacon grease, or just some lubricant you buy at the store. I sometimes use WD-40. Because I like it. And then you want to be sure you wear safety glasses because this thing kicks up a bunch of metal shavings straight up into your face, like it aims for your eyes. So wear glasses. Okay, so I have that part cut out with a jigsaw, and there's parts in here like right here, possibly underneath her armpits, that will be hard to cut out with the jigsaw just by itself. So you're gonna have to cut some holes where there's a sharp turn, and you can either use a drill or a torch. I like to use a torch because it's faster. You could cut the whole thing out with a torch, but I don't have the right size tip for this thin sheet metal. And I have a plasma cutter, so I probably won't ever get one. But you could do this. This is a good way to do it too. It's cheaper than using a torch for the whole thing, and it's almost as fast.
So now you can stick the blade in that hole.
Okay, so here it is all cut out. The waste is kind of thick, but it's going to roll over, so it'll be all right. We're going to cut little slits in it. Okay, so now I'm just going to draw where I'm going to hammer it. I'm just going to make a center line because that helps me figure everything out. And let's see, her shoulders. That's about where her collarbone is. And her little, whatever that little thing under your throat is called. She's gonna have a little bulge right there. That's about where her boobs will be. And her ripped abs will be right here. Okay, here's a tool similar to the one that I used at school.
it's just a bunch of pipe fittings attached to whatever you want, and then you can just hit the metal inside of them. I don't necessarily like this one too much because
when you're hitting your metal, if you don't hit it exactly in there correctly, like if you accidentally hit it right there, it'll leave blemishes on your metal, and I can't stand that. Plus, there's some threading in here that I haven't ground out, and those can leave some blemishes on your piece too. So I made this one over here. I made this one to give to someone, but they never got it. What I like about this one is that there's this all this flat area, so if you accidentally hit it over here, it won't leave such a nasty blemish as that other machine, that other thing. Plus, it's smoother, and also this shape right here comes in handy. And I just like this one a lot more than that other one. But they'll both work, and the other one's easier to make than this one. You can make the other one actually with those cheap tools that I told you. Okay, so what I'm going to do is take this sheet, and then I'm going to take this hammer, put it over these holes and hit it in the hole. Okay, so I've been hammering it for a bit, and as you can see, it's starting to take shape from the side. When you're hammering it, it's going to get like this, but don't worry because you can fix that later. But basically, I just want to get the basic shape, and you see how they're kind of rounded? I want them to be like come out more like this. So I drew inside some little circles where I need to start hammering more. That'll help me out. Okay, so here it is so far. I gotta fill that a little bit more. Now I'm gonna do the abdomen. Got it kind of marked out in here. Okay, so here it is so far. As you can see, it's starting to take shape. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a little bit around there, and this I'm gonna put a cut right here, and then I'm gonna pull it up. Here I cut some slits so I can pull the metal up and bring it back into shape. I could just use a cross peen and hammer it all around all the humps and stuff, but it would make it flat. This way it could still have some kind of curve. Here I'm hammering the waist round on that piece of solid pipe that I had the other day. Here I'm doing the neck. I had to really cut out a lot because to keep this under 10 minutes, but here's the first one I made. It's got more detail than this one because I'm going to go back in and use the torch and fill in the collar, the little dimple below the throat and the shoulder blades and the chest part above the breast. I'm going to sink it in and I'm going to make the boobs more teardrop shaped instead of so round, and I'm going to do that all with heat. I'm going to show them both to you because this one has more detail, but I used those pipes, and as you can see, it left a bunch of blemishes. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. It still looks really neat, but I don't like to grind afterwards and polish and fill with wax, so I like to use the other one because I don't have to do all that because it's a lot smoother looking. There's not, even if I miss, it won't make those craters. So in the next installment, I'm going to fix it up, make the boobs more teardropped, put the nipples and the belly button on, and make a face, and use the heat to show you how to forge better, and I'll clean it up. Goodbye.